Hi everyone, this is Grace and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to learn how to decorate these beginner thank you cookies. Now these are some of the very first lettered thank you cookies that I ever did, so I think it's a great way to show you some beginner techniques, and I certainly didn't have as many tools as I do now, so here we go. First up, I am outlining and flooding this cookie. Now, this is a very basic plaque from Ann Clark Cookie Cutters. You can find this on Amazon, and I will link this in the description of the video. I chose to do one consistency outline and flood here, but if you're a real beginner and struggling with your consistencies, I might suggest doing two consistencies for this because you're going to be adding sprinkles in a minute, and it can be a little tough to add sprinkles because they really encourage the icing to spread out. And if you're not quite sure of how much icing to do in your consistency, you're more likely to get some spillover. So just keep that in mind. If you are doing one consistency and you're a beginner, I also suggest not flooding all the way to the edge. Here I did, but if you leave a couple millimeters on the edge of your cookie, then it gives you a little more leeway if your icing does spread out a bit. So for the sprinkles here, I'm just using basic Wilton sprinkles. It's nothing fancy. It's not one of these fancy sprinkle mixes. You can see that my finger has been dyed by the sprinkles. I think I picked three or four different individual sprinkles that you can find from Wilton, and then I combine them together to get kind of the fancy sprinkle mix effect that I was going for. And I love this technique of using sprinkles like this. It's just this kind of cascade effect coming down from the top. You do more sprinkles toward the top and a little less as you go down. And it frames the space nicely for whatever words you want to add to it. If you don't have a specialized hand lettered plaque like the next cookie we'll do in this video, this is a great way to kind of make it seem more intentional that you're framing whatever word it is that you're putting on the cookie. So here I am again. I'm using tips here. When I first started, I used piping tips. This is a PME 1.5. It was my favorite tip for piping lettering. So again, I'll link that in the description of this video. And here I'm doing a pretty basic pressure piping lettering. And when I say basic, it just means I'm doing an all level lettering. It's not the kind of bouncy lettering that I do now, but for that I use a projector, and here I'm not using a projector. Pressure piping is when you're adjusting the amount of pressure on your bag, and you apply more pressure as you're going down on your downstroke, and you release the pressure as you're going up. Now, I practiced this lettering many, many times on parchment paper beforehand. That's the best way to do it when you're freehanding like I just did. And I really do think that it is important to do some freehanding, even if you have a projector, but it's really is where you start to get comfortable with lettering. So I encourage practicing on parchment paper. And you can also, when that surface of the cookie is dry, you can also practice on food grade cellophane bags on top of your dry cookie so you can really see what it looks like, get the right size, etc. So here I am. I am painting with highlighter here. Today I more typically use an edible dust. This is often used on cakes, and I will link this in the description of the video. If you're going to be painting on top of your lettering like this, always do your letters the same color as your base flood, because it's almost impossible to perfectly paint. So if you don't perfectly paint it, the color of the letters will just seep into the color of the base of the cookie. Make sure that your letters are dry before you paint. And that is that basic thank you cookie. They're really simple, but I really like making them, and I still like them today. Now, I mentioned this concept of hand lettering, and that's what this cookie cutter is. If you're going to get a hand lettered cookie cutter, this is the first one that I recommend for everyone. First of all, it's a thank you cookie, and we can always use a cookie that says thank you. Even if your cookie set is not thank you based, you can always use it to just give your client as a extra bonus thank you cookie. And the reason that I recommend this cookie cutter, because I really feel like it so beautifully hugs the word thank you, and it guides it really well when you are learning to freehand lettering without a projector. This cutter, of course, is Kleidacuts. Y'all know at this point that I'm a big fan of Kleidacuts. Heather does beautiful lettering and beautiful cutters. So again, here I am doing a one consistency outline in Flood. This was just for ease. I'm not doing any sprinkles, so I'm not quite as concerned about the consistency itself. I just wanna outline and flood this and allow that to dry. You wanna allow that to dry almost completely before doing this next step. Now, I'm just using pure gel food coloring and I mixed it with water. You can also mix it with a very high alcohol content alcohol like Everclear, that would be my favorite. Some vodkas do work too, but if you're using alcohol, the liquid is going to evaporate a lot quicker and so you have to work even faster. But if you're using water, it stays more liquidy a lot longer and just gives you a little more flexibility. I'm doing a rainbow technique here, and I prefer to do a rainbow with just the primary colors of red, yellow, green, and then making the orange and red, yellow, and blue, and then you make the green, as you can see here, by mixing the yellow and the blue together, and I feel like that gets you the most genuine rainbow effect, and that's what I was going for. So I've allowed that to dry. Something you can do, which I did not do here, to help food gel coloring dry without that tackiness, is after it has basically dried, then you just dust it very lightly with cornstarch, and that will kind of help the colors set and it won't be tacky anymore. So here I am, again, I'm doing pressure piping lettering where my downstrokes, I'm adding more pressure to the bag, and then I'm releasing my pressure as I go up. And you can see here, it's just so easy to pipe the letters on this cookie cutter because it's really made for it. So it's a great visual guide for where you should be placing all of your letters. And it's just a kind of cute design that adds a little pizzazz with that Y at the end. And it's really kind of like, I think it's almost musical, the way that the letters bounce. I'm doing the same technique I did on the first cookie where I have allowed those letters to dry and now I'm painting them with highlighter. This is Truly Mad Plastics and I'll link this in the description of the video. I am using Everclear here. It is very important to use and alcohol, high alcohol content, clear alcohol when painting any sort of dust like this, any sort of metallic dust. And don't worry, the alcohol evaporates and dries. That's why you use alcohol, because it will, the liquid will completely evaporate and then it will just dry and it will be beautiful. It is really hard, I will say, to paint letters. So a true beginner version of this would be to not paint your letters at all. Use a different color than white on this, something that pops, something that looks good, or you could just leave this white because I painted the base of this cookie for that first cookie. You could do blue letters, silver letters, or excuse me, it would be more like gray letters. But I was in a phase of my life, of my cookie life, where I liked to paint all of my letters. It also takes a lot more time, my friends. So give yourself more time if you are painting. You know, it's been a long time actually since I've used this cutter and it makes me think I should use it again, but it is a classic in the cookie world. I have it in a lot of different sizes. Definitely recommend. And I can't express enough when it comes to lettering, getting better at it is to practice. There is a lettering guide by Bossy Brushstrokes that I will link in the description of this video. And I've used that to practice and I really recommend that as well. So there we have it. There's two beginner lettering options for thank you cookies. And I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you enjoy making these cookies yourself one day.